Hi, this will be my second video on the subject of making a player-controlled walk using the Renpy engine. There will be a link in the description to this video, to the first video. What we did in the first video was to have a player character that walked to a point that was indicated by a mouse click. And the walk was limited to the area shown on the screen. What we are going to do now is the same thing, but instead of moving the character on the screen, the character will have a fixed position and the background is going to move. This makes it possible to have a much larger room to walk in. The script for this version of the walk will be very similar to the script for the first version of the walk. We are going to use quite similar images. The images for the character will be the same images, only a larger version of those images. So we will have 6 images that makes up a walk cycle, and one of those images will double as the stand image. The background will be different though. In the first version, the background only had to be the size of the screen. In this case, we have a background that has the same height as the screen, but it is much wider. At each end of the room in this image, we have an area that will not be walkable. That area need to be about half the width of the screen. As the player cannot walk to the edge of the screen, the edge of the room must be able to come to the character. We will have almost the same variables in this script as in the last one. We will have SX and SY for the position of the character. In this case, these numbers will be the same in all cases, so they are not variables, but rather constants. We will have a variable MX for the position, the X position of the mouse pointer. We will have a variable for the distance between MX and the character. We will also have a variable that shows whether the character is standing still or walking. If stand walk is 0, the character is standing still, and if it is 1, the character is walking. The variable rx is new. This is the x position of the background or the room, and we set that to -1000 for the start position. The rx value will always be a negative number. Well, 0 or a negative number, since 0 is as far to the left as you can get on the image, and when we are walking to the right, the image will be moving to the left and into the negative numbers. We will then have a screen called check mouse, and this is the same as we had in the previous script. If the stand walk variable is 0, that is, if the character is standing still, this screen will check if the left mouse button is clicked, and if so, jump to the label check dist. The labels we have in this script are the same as we had in the previous script. We of course have a start label where we show the background as a scene and set it at the starting position, the starting X position, and we show the screen so it can start checking for mouse clicks. We have the labels stand right, stand left, and walk right and walk left. And finally, we have the label check dist. This was the label that the screen will jump to when it detects a mouse click. In stand right and stand left, we start off by setting stand walk to 0. This ensures that the screen is listening for mouse clicks. We show the stand image at the X position and the Y position, and we have a hard pause that makes certain that the script is not continuing until we get a mouse click. The only difference between stand right and stand left is that we are using X zoom to flip the stand image left or right depending on which direction the character is facing. When we get a mouse click, the script jumps down to label check dist, where we start setting mx to the value of the x position of the mouse pointer. The width of the screen in this game is 640 pixels, so 320 is the middle of the x direction. We compare the MX value to 320 and we get the distance between MX and 320, and we then jump to walk right or walk left depending on if MX is to the right or to the left of 320. We have some more script for each of these two alternatives that I will return to in a short while. But we start with jumping to the walk right or the walk left labels. There we start with setting stand walk 1. This will ensure that the screen will not be looking for any mouse clicks. In the labels we show the background starting with its present X position, and we then use a linear move to move to a new X position, which will be RX minus the distance or plus the distance depending on which direction the character is to walk. The time for the movement we set to distance divided with 100. This means that a movement of 100 pixels will be done in 1 second. We are using 100.0 to make certain that the time will be in the data type float. Otherwise we would get an integer, and all distances below 100 pixels would have the time 0, which would not be good. We show the animated walk cycle at the X and Y position of the character. We have a pause that is the length of the time for the walk, and we set RX to the new final position of the background after the movement, and then we jump to the stand position that is the same direction as the walk. Also with walk right and walk left, we are using X zoom to flip the images left or right depending on what direction the character is to walk. Now let's go back to check dist and see additional script we had there. This additional script is to prevent the character from walking outside the walkable area. If we have a RX that is less than minus 4067 or more than minus 351, the character will be outside the walkable area. So in a situation where the player clicks outside the walkable area in the X direction, the distance will only be set to a number that will make the character walk to the last point that is inside the walkable area. So this way it is not possible for the player to get the character to walk further than the room allows. Yeah, well, that was pretty much it. So, for now, see you later. Bye!